Presenting yearly efficacy and safety outcomes over 4 years after last alemtuzumab course in pooled CAREMS 1 and 2 patients by number of additional courses received through year 9. In the CAREMS and 2 studies, 2 courses of alemtuzumab demonstrated significantly greater improvement in clinical and MRI outcomes versus subcutaneous interferon beta 1a over 2 years. Efficacy was maintained over an additional 7 years in 2 consecutive extension studies, CAREMS extension and ongoing TOPAZ study. Additional courses of alemtuzumab were permitted in the extensions on as needed basis, given more than 12 months apart. Other disease-modifying therapies were also permitted. Adverse events associated with alemtuzumab treatment in clinical trials at most marketing experience include infusion association reactions, increased frequency of infection, and the potential for opportunistic infections, secondary autoimmunity, such as thyroid disorders, immune thrombocytopenia, nephropathies, autoimmune cytopenias, autoimmune hepatitis, and other less common autoimmune events, acute acalculus cholecystitis, and cardiovascular and pulmonary events possibly related to infusions. Study rationale and objective: to evaluate the efficacy and safety of additional alemtuzumab courses over 4 years after the last course. Alemtuzumab is administered as 2 courses, but additional courses may be given if needed. Over 9 years, 49% of CAREMS patients received more than 1 additional course of alemtuzumab. Criteria for additional courses in the CAREMS extension were either more than 1 protocol-defined relapse or more than 2 new enlarging T2 hyperintense or gadolinium-enhancing brain or spinal cord lesions. And in the TOPAZ, there were no specifically defined criteria and were at the discretion of the treating neurologist. Decision to administer additional courses was left to the treating physician. Reasons for retreatment were relapses in 74% of cases and MRI activity in 44% of cases. And obviously in some of those cases, the 2 reasons coincided. Methods. Analysis population included pooled CAREMS 1 and 2 alemtuzumab treated patients who received exactly 2 courses, meaning no additional course was given, exactly 3 courses, meaning 1 additional course was administered, and those patients who received more than 4 courses, meaning that more than 2 additional courses were deemed required. Analysis inclusion criteria: patient had to receive additional alemtuzumab by months 97 to allow more than 12 months of follow-up, and they had to be on no other DMTs. In the more than 4 courses group, patients who received more than 5 courses were censored at the time of course 5 administration. Outcomes data were re-baselined after the last alemtuzumab course. Disposition by number of alemtuzumab courses received. So the alemtuzumab in the course study was received by 811 of patients. Out of them, 742 patients entered the extension phase. 114, or 15% of those, did not meet analysis criteria to enter into this particular analysis. Those patients who received exactly 2 courses were therefore 48%, or 359 patients, and out of them, patients who remained in year 4 after the last course were 88%. Patients who received exactly 3 courses, meaning 1 additional course, were 20%, or 148 patients, and out of them, remained in study in year 4 after their last course of alemtuzumab were 65%, or 96 patients. Those patients who required 4 courses, meaning more than two additional courses, where 16% of all population, or 121 patients, and those patients who remained out of them in study up to year four after the last course were 37 or 31%. Analyzed relapse rate after receiving additional alemtuzumab courses. So practically, here are the values reported for the follow-up, and analyzed relapse rate was estimated through negative B nominal regression with robust variance estimation. And the total courses received are presented here. In those patients who only received standard two courses, so did not have any additional courses, we can see that analyzed relapse rate through year four remains in very low numbers. And up to year four, that number achieves 0.7 analyzed relapse rate numbers. Those patients who required one additional course and had three courses in total, their analyzed relapse rate data remained at low numbers, and by year four, we're at the point of 0.07. The patients with higher disease activities, with more relapses, and meeting criteria for more than two additional courses, nevertheless achieved quite a stability after getting those required additional courses, and their level of analyzed relapse rate of year two through four remained at the level of 0.2 up to 0.23. Disability after receiving additional alemtuzumab course. So here we look at the outcomes based on the EDSS, mean EDSS score after receiving additional courses if they were needed. So for comparison, those patients who did not require additional courses, their EDSS was very stable and remained at the slightly above two and did not really fluctuate up to year four. And those patients who required one additional course, they also stabilized at slightly higher level, and their EDSS change from baseline was plus 0.8, not significant, and that was stable through year four. Those patients who required additional more than two courses and had more than four courses altogether have shown more of the EDSS fluctuation, and their change from the baseline was plus 0.56, and nevertheless, the certain stability was obtained, even though with higher degree of fluctuation, as could be expected in this more challenging for treatment subgroup of patients. The important question for the new times is the 6 months confirmed disability improvement, and what percentage of patients can in fact achieve improvement as a result of their treatments. We can see that in those patients who only had two courses and received zero additional courses, there was continuous increase of percentage of patients who achieved the 6 months confirmed disability improvement, which is defined as more than 1 point decrease in EDSS score from baseline confirmed over 6 months. And that is obviously assessed in those patients whose EDSS at the baseline was more than two. And those patients who required one additional course were also showing continuous increase of percentage of patients who achieved confirmed disability improvement, and by year four, that percentage got to the 11%, which basically was continuous increase as compared to initial 4% in year one, post the last alemtuzumab treatment, and got to 11% by year 4. Those patients who required more than 2 additional courses, here we can see also this show continuous increase in percentage of patients achieving confirmed disability improvement, and those numbers were 5% year 1, 8% year 2, 10% year 3, and by year 4, 15% of those patients in the more challenging clinical group have achieved confirmed disability improvement. 6 months confirmed disability worsening is another way of looking at the population of patients. And those patients who were free from 6 months confirmed disability worsening in percentages are presented here. And as you can see, in those patients requiring 0 additional courses, the percentage of patients completely free from confirmed disability worsening, which is defined as more than 1 point increase in EDSS score, or more than 1.5 point increase if baseline was merely 0, confirmed over 6 months. And here you can see that the numbers are quite high, indicating that higher percentage of patients were free from 6 months confirmed disability worsening. And by year 4, it was 83%, showing no evidence of worsening. In patients who required one additional course, the percentage of patients by year 4 who did not show any evidence of worsening was 85%. And remarkably, in those patients who required more than 2 additional courses, percentage of patients who did not show any worsening by year 4 was 94%. So the vast majority of patients were free from 6 months confirmed disability worsening after they received the number of additional courses they clinically required. MRI disease activity after receiving additional alemtuzumab courses are presented here. So patients free from MRI disease activity, which was defined as no new gadolinium-enhancing lesions and no new enlarging T2 hyperintense lesions since their last MRI. We can see that in patients with 0 additional courses, the percentage by year 4 was 78% free from MRI disease activity. Patients who had 1 additional course, 73% by year 4. And those patients who required more than 2 additional courses, still percentage of patients who were free from disease activity presented on MRI was close to 70% by year 4 at 69.23. Adverse events after additional alemtuzumab courses are presented here in this table. And what we can basically see is that data for the patients who received more than 4 courses altogether, meaning more than 2 additional courses, are clearly lower, and the patients had known to have a higher comorbidity rates. Nevertheless, it's important for us to note that the serious infections were perhaps presented at somewhat higher degree in this particular group. Conclusions. Although the more than 4 courses group had higher disease activity and disability as expected, additional alemtuzumab stabilized disease over 4 years. Patients who received 1 additional course of alemtuzumab, 3 courses total, had clinical and MRI outcome consistent with those of patients who did not require additional courses. Alemtuzumab safety was generally consistent between groups. Overall infections declined over time in all patient groups, although the more than 4 courses group had an increase in serious infections in year 4, from 1.4% to 5.4%. There was no increased incidence of thyroid adverse events after receiving additional alemtuzumab courses. Lower number of available patients may have limited the interpretation of the more than four courses group in year four after the last course. Therefore, more attention and follow-up are needed for this group. And the authors and Sanfi thank the patients for their participation in the trial, as well as the CAREMS 1 and 2 steering committee and investigators, and the extension studies investigators.